Well, it's no mean feat being a part of the biggest movie franchise of all time. You know all eyes are going to be upon you. Our eyes are on Riz Ahmed and Felicity Jones tonight. Riz, first of all, a boy from Wembley. You're here for the Star Wars launch in London. You're in it. That's pretty good, isn't it?
Yeah, I guess so. Yeah, I'll be proud, Mum. Yeah, just kind of pinching myself a little bit, you know. Like so many people of my generation, I've kind of grown up watching these movies and kind of revering them. So to be a part of it is kind of surreal.
And Riz, you know, when you were filming at Pinewood, what I want to know is, did you stay at home with Mum? Were you in a hotel? Were you really Hollywood about it? What did you do?
That's actually a really good point. My parents, because they're from Wembley, we're quite close to Pinewood. So throughout the whole of the shoot, I was living at home with my parents. No one's actually thought to ask that. So on one hand, I'm kind of living my dreams, like, yeah, made it in Hollywood. On the other hand, I'm like, coming back to Mum. She's like, have you eaten? Clear up your room. It's like quite an interesting juxtaposition.
That is so cool. Now, you've had a fantastic year, Riz, both as Riz MC, the rapper, also with your acting. Has it come to a point now where you're at a crossroads, you have to make a decision? Do you carry on rapping or do you act?
Well, you know, I think these days, people kind of don't mind you doing more than one thing. Now, the fact is, a lot of kids will be just getting all their content from YouTube, whether it's music or video clips or short films. And for me, I think it creates a healthy balance. You know, I have to be careful about what films I do, because every time I do one, it means I can't go in the studio. So it creates a kind of healthy tension for me.
And yesterday, a nomination for a Golden Globe. Congratulations. What an end to the year.
Yeah, thank you. Thank you. It's a real surprise and honor to be up there with those amazing actors, particularly with John Turturro, my friend. So, yeah, thank you.
And certainly somebody who's no stranger to nominations for massive awards, including Oscars, Golden Globes and BAFTAs, Felicity Jones. What's it feel like for you with the success you've had going to Pinewood, the home of Star Wars, the home of Bond? Are you pretty blasé about it, or is it still exciting?
Oh no, it's so exciting, especially when you turn up at 4 a.m. in the morning and you're driving in and you get to see the wonderful image of James Bond coming in. And also, I have to say, Sigourney Weaver is also up there from Alien. But it's quite good when you're driving into work, because it really kind of gets you motivated seeing those icons as you're about to go into your trailer and get ready.
And a girl from Bourneville in Birmingham, you've made it to the casting of one of the biggest movies of all time. That's a pretty good journey, isn't it?
Yeah, it has. It is. I mean, as Riz said, it's one of those moments where you kind of do keep pinching yourself throughout the whole process, and particularly making something like Star Wars, where, you know, I've grown up. I remember Darth Vader so vividly and being on that kind of checkerboard and then suddenly to be filming with him is quite a strange experience.
And Gareth Edwards, the director, he was brought up not a million miles away from you in Nuneaton. You know, when you were speaking to him, did you ever slip into a Brummie accent or just come out with little colloquialisms?
Well, we would also, I could feel that there was a real kind of connection between us immediately when we met, because there's actually a very similar sense of humour, Birmingham sense of humour. And also, I think there's Birmingham people have a good way of not taking themselves too seriously, and I feel like we share that, I hope.
Now, one thing I have to ask, something that I noticed about the film and the two of you, and that was, it broke the mould of traditional casting. You were a strong, feisty woman who held her own. Riz, there's you, an Asian actor, but it didn't matter that you're Asian, you're just an actor, you're just the pilot. Do you think this was breaking the mould for Hollywood?
You know, I think it just feels quite natural and right. It's 2016, and these days, if you tell a story, you tell it to the world, whether people are watching it at home, streaming on their computers or TVs, or if they're going to multiplexes from, you know, Jakarta to California. If you tell a story, you're telling it to everyone. So I think it's just right and timely that our stories reflect the audiences that are going to see them.
And a good role model for young women as well.
Absolutely, absolutely. You know, to play a woman who goes from, as do all the rebels actually, they go from being outsiders to feeling a little bit lost to finding something that they believe in, and their strength actually is in their differences, and they manage to have great unity and focus. I guess what makes Jin a role model is that her leadership is very much through collaboration. It's not through any sort of dictatorship.
Okay, Felicity, Riz, congratulations on a really exciting film. I did enjoy watching it, and the film is on general release in your cinemas from Thursday.